Hi, welcome back to Retro Tech. Today we're going to be talking about CRT deflection yokes. Now, whether you're using a consumer CRT or a high-end professional video monitor or even something like an arcade monitor, they're all going to have a deflection yoke in them. And those deflection yokes tend to look something like this. So today we're going to do a closer look at the deflection yoke. We're going to see what it does on the screen and why it's so important to CRTs. Let's go through some of the details real quickly here on this yoke. So this is our cable where our power and control is coming in, and it's going to also be spreading that electricity through our coils. And then that electricity will actually travel back through this and back through the board and on a path to help amplify the CRT gun beam so it has enough electricity to shoot. We need to take a quick second to look at these coils, because if this is energized, there's an opportunity for us to really hurt ourselves if we were to brush against this and there's some live electricity coming through this. Let's talk about what adjustments you can make on your yoke. Now again, just remember to avoid any of this copper wiring while this is installed. And the first thing you'll notice are your rings up here. A lot of times these are epoxied together originally, either in the manufacturing facility or in the field sometimes if it was set up for a specific purpose. Here's a closer look at these rings, and these are again referred to as our convergence rings. Now normally, if you didn't have your build up here of old epoxy, you would be able to freely turn a couple of these and they will control individual color beams on your screen, and that's the way you line them up in succession so that you get solid colors that don't have a separation of red, green, and blue. So before we jump into a live demonstration, let's look at where this deflection lens was placed originally on this particular tube. We'll use another tube for the demonstration, but today we're looking at this tube. So you can see our electron gun inside here, and then this area where the tube arcs and bevels out is where the lens will be over. Now, you gotta be very careful if you're taking and removing this lens, because you're going around one of the weakest parts of the CRT. I've opened up here a Panasonic 13-inch professional video monitor, and we're gonna take a look at this yoke today. This is gonna be our test monitor. I wanna go through some things on how the yoke is in place and what we can do to make adjustments. And you need to know that to make an adjustment on this yoke, a first thing, you need to know what's holding it in place. Occasionally you'll have them set up like this one where you've got more than one screw. So this one has a screw right here where I'm touching, and then there's a second screw right here. And both of these screws need to be loosened in order to adjust this yoke. To give you an idea of the adjustments or the problems that might happen with your yoke, this one's loosened and you can see right away that it goes left and right rather easily. Now please note that this is not energized and I've taken all the proper safety precautions to be working in here. Please, before you do any adjustment like this, make sure you familiarize yourself with all safety precautions for a CRT. I have plenty of safety videos on my channel. Please familiarize yourself with those techniques before getting in here. Again, it's turned off, but I want you to see how it freely turns left and right along the glass tube. And also, the other problem is when it's not pushed up against the yoke, it's either too close to the tube or it's a little bit away from it, and it either leans left, right, up, or down, or it's just pushed back a little bit. And what that causes is it'll cause an extreme color distortion along the edges of our tube. All right, so first things first, you can easily notice that our yoke is tilted because our picture is tilted. And the first thing, most of the time, adjustments, this is a common yoke adjustment where you might see a screen that's been tilted like this, and that's fairly simple. I've got my gloves on, and I'm just gonna, of course, turn that till it's parallel on the tops and bottoms. Again, to make this adjustment, we're just gonna use this yoke assembly, and we're gonna turn it clockwise or counterclockwise to make sure that we have it level on our screen picture. Okay, so again, after we've gotten our screen leveled out, this is a great screen to use on the 240p test suite, because you can see how you are completely across. But the next thing to notice is this discoloration here and this discoloration here. This is because our yoke is either tilted or it's just a little bit too far back against the yoke rings, or the convergence rings. The yoke is just a little too far back and it's not close enough to the tube, so it's not doing its full job of the lens deflecting all the colors out to where they're supposed to be with the magnetism. Sorry about switching the inputs there, but I hope you just saw how I got it up and lined up. Just when it happened, look all our color. It's completely normal now. So if you have edge coloring miscolors, it could be because the yoke is just slightly off and it's not fully centered and right up against the back of that tube. Let's take a look at the tube now. So that's why these little rubber stoppers, you'll notice there's about three or four of them on the back of your CRT tube. They are there to hold that ring in place and get it snug right in the right spot so that you don't have any tilting on it or any kind of distortion along the edges of your picture. So once you've got your yoke set in the right position, come back to your screen area and make sure you tighten up the two screws that you loosened in order to make your adjustment. And try your best not to move anything, keep everything still, take your time, and slowly tighten those screws. Well, that's going to conclude our video today on yokes, and I hope you learned something. Please, if you have any comments, leave them below. And as always, thank you so much to the patrons who have decided to help out with the channel and support it. Also, if you're looking for any kind of repair on a CRT, please follow the patron page because that's how repairs are done through our shop, through the patron page. Thanks again. I'm Steve. Have a great day.